Okay, so hello everybody and welcome to today's live market session and analysis. As you can see, today's the profit. We are able to get a very good profit, right? And again, as we said, it's a hedged system, so we can you can see the buy leg over here, right? You can see they are both for the next expiry, and then we have the sell leg for the current expiry, as explained in my yesterday video also, right? Now currently, if we look at the market, right, and let us go and look at the market. As we discussed, this was the range for Bank Nifty, where it was facing multiple issues, a lot of issues. Earlier it acted as a support, and now here it is slowing down the pace. And because it is slowing down the pace, you can see all the premiums, be it call and put, they're slowly losing their value over here, right? Like I can let us take 32,500. Yesterday it was we sold it around two lots, covered one lot now around 20, and here you can see it is continuously trading below the VWAP also, and continuously it is under the pressure. Now coming to this 33,500 also, that again we had two lot, one lot I booked around 40, right? That also you can see it is currently under the pressure, right? And it was a hedge position, and that is what it is required. We had multiple positions, and now I'll be closing it, as now some options have become 2 rupees and something, so I'll be closing it within next 1 to 2 hours. Market is now currently, you can see it is still dancing in this small zone, right? Dancing in the small zone, it needs to break down below this 33,000 level, and then we'll get a space on the downside, or it has to go above this 33,300, then we'll get a space till here. Within this zone, it is just about eating the premiums. So selling, if you are thinking about selling the options now, you have to be cautious, because already the premium value has been lost quite substantially, and even now for the small move, the premium might just explode, right? So this is one account, and this is another account where I take positional that I have taken, right? This I use with different systems, with different logic. I sometimes go aggressive, so or yeah, over here. So here you can also see the profit is building around 13k. So the important thing is that if everything is done in a logical manner, not haphazard manner, or not as per the bias that you form, right? We have a rule based process or system that we follow. We understand the price action structure, and based after that only then we put our entries in the market. So it is a like a game of chess. You cannot just come form a view straight away and take the entries. It does not work like that. You have to kind of be patient for your entries, and then you have to take the move, and most importantly manage the risk. Whatever the risk you have defined, if the market is hitting your risk limit, you have to respect it and then get out. And another important thing is that profit booking, you should also know when to book the profits. That is also very important, and rather than booking at one go, always make a habit to book partial profits and ride the remaining with quantity with the market. This might seem that okay, sometimes you might give some part of the profit, let's say 20-30% profits back to the market, but most importantly this will help you to reduce the emotions in the market, right? So this what we did yesterday, the more of the setups they are continuing, the more of the premiums you are seeing, they are continuing over here, right? And that is why I won't go into explanation, because yesterday we explained that within this zone we'll be looking for selling opportunities, and it's a sideways market, right? So premiums will fall down, and from next Thursday second half, that is either from today's second half or from tomorrow, if it breaks above or below this range, you will see a spurt in the option premiums, and also the big move will come for Nifty. Nifty on other hand is much bullish than Bank Nifty. It has broken this range quite convincingly, Right, now you can see this is hourly chart. It has broken the range quite convincingly. Now it's up to the Bank Nifty. If it wants to go above 15,000, right? If it wants to go above 15,000 now, the Bank Nifty has to break above 33,300. So now you, what as a new trader, if you want to make new positions, because Nifty has already moved much. Now, if it wants to continue the momentum, it is the turn of Bank Nifty. If Bank Nifty breaks down below 33,000 also at the same time, what you will see is that Nifty won't be able to sustain over here and it will be pushed back into this range by the market, right? So now it is make or break for both things. If it wants to go above 15,000, Bank Nifty has to break 33,300 to 500 zone. It has to break that shackles and go above, right? Or else it will be very difficult, because Reliance has been supporting it, HDFC, TCS, they have been supporting it from past few days, and now they are stretched, they are also at the upper part of the limit. So now it's up to the next heavyweights, which is the Bank Nifty. The banking stocks need to support the index to go above this, right? And that is what is a correlation you can find in between the two. And you can look for it if you want also the shorting opportunities in Nifty. You need to let it come below the range, and at the same time Bank Nifty should also break down below 33,000 or 32,900 33,000, the range that we saw. So this is a very important thing, right? And now the move depends on how Bank Nifty react, because it has a good weightage in Nifty. Coming to the stocks, you can see TCS today, it made again a very big candle. It broke above the consolidation range of past 2 days. So it's very good for positional. For intraday, it has already moved much. You need to either wait for the retracement, or you need to then look for reversal setup in a smaller time frame, right? So the reversal setup, we teach in our price action program, where we tell how to take the reversal, how to identify the market structure and where to time a reversal, which is very important. So ideally below 3300 we can look for reversal setups in it, right? HDFC again, same thing, good 15 minute candle and then sideways. So that is what they are doing. It's just index management. Nifty is now hovering between 14900 to 15,000, and it is just waiting for Bank Nifty to break above, to go above, if it wants to go above. Or if Bank Nifty breaks below, then it will again come back. All this HDFC and everything, they can support to a limit, but after that it is about the next heavyweights, right? So coming to the banking stocks, if you look at this ICICI Bank, right? If you look at ICICI Bank, again it opened in 15 minutes and again it is now coming to the previous day high of it. If you look at the Kotak Banks, it is inside PDH PDL, it is trying to break up, right? But the structure, the volumes are very quite low over here. And the main, the HDFC Bank, if you look again, same thing, opened little bit gap up and then move. So it's now up to HDFC Bank and ICICI Bank. If they both are able to push from here, right, this is the zone, an important zone for them, then you can see a good Bank Nifty would be able to break the range. Most importantly, HDFC Bank should be able to push above the day high for Bank Nifty to break the range. That is very, very, very important. So that we are just consolidating in a low volume structure in both the index, right? So that is very important. And for aggressive, if they want to take positions, right? Let's say for aggressive trade, if you want to take positions in Nifty, then you can look for shorting opportunity once we break down below 14,900. A convincing breakdown below 14,900 can give you a good shorting position. So hope you have learned something from it. The profit is now going to around 33K. So some positions had been booked yesterday, some we are carrying, right? And definitely we had also now partially booked some of the profit from the call side, because now market, if it is trying to go, it can go up very fast, because that zone is very important. So then we'll see how it if which direction it breaks the range. That is very important, right? So we'll keep monitor it accordingly. I have told you the range. Hope you understand the logic behind it. द लॉजिक बिहाइंड द ट्रेड्स यू टेक, ट्रेड इन अ डिसिप्लिन्ड वे, डो नॉट कंपेयर योर एम टू एम विथ अदर्स, राइट, एंड मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंटली बी पेशेंट वाइल ट्रेडिंग एंड बी हम्बल, दैट इज़ वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट. मार्केट्स विल टीच यू, राइट, इफ़ यू स्टे लॉजिकल एंड इफ़ यू रिस्पेक्ट वॉट इट इज़ ट्राइंग टू कम्युनिकेट विथ यू. इफ़ यू आर ईगोइस्टिक विद रिस्पेक्ट टू मार्केट, इट विल काइंड ऑफ कम एंड पनिश यू ऑन इट्स ओन टर्म, राइट. सो विल जस्ट रिफ्रेश इट वन लास्ट टाइम एंड लेट अस सी. यस, 32,685 अराउंड वॉट इट इज शोइंग नाउ, राइट. सो दैट्स इट फॉर टुडे. होप यू लर्न समथिंग न्यू फ्रॉम इट. विल मीट टुमारो, right, I'll be taking some of the positions for next expiry either in the second half of the day. Once I am able to close the positions, definitely they'll be on a debit side, because the market now can go into premium expansion. Suddenly you can see a spike in the premium depending on the direction which the market breaks, right. Yeah, and again Maruti also one is a good, that's when going into consolidation. Maruti also one can look, if it breaks down the range, it will also give you a good selling setup. So these are the some basic stocks, right, that you can look into. And if you haven't joined our Telegram channel, you're welcome to do so. Here we put the pre-open charts and explain you with logic how to trade in the market. That is very important. Okay, so thank you for your time. Thank you for watching the video. Bye bye. God bless you.